Good show.
Hey man, I don't think you should be riding so close to this car in front of us. Have you ever heard of following distance? It's the recommended distance between you and the car in front of you while you're driving.
Yeah, I didn't learn this. This is our fast one driving last time.
Yeah, we're driving, yeah.
How'd you get here? Hey, this is Ben. I'm here to give some visual aid and leeway to the concept that I just described to David. Now, I would use Matchbox cars as visual aid, but I didn't have any, so I guess 9-volt batteries will have to do. Yeah. Okay, so say this is your car, and this is the car in front of you. You want to have a good 2 to 3 distance cars between the two of you to have a safe distance. So let's imagine these are also cars. 1, 2, and 3. That would give you a safe distance. Also, if you combine your reaction time with your speed, that'll give you a safe distance between have you and the car in front of you.
Whoa, dude, you just drove a yellow light. That was really close.
Well, I don't know all the factors. I don't know what I should have been doing.
Well, you should take into account always how wide the intersection is, your response time, your speed, brakes, and yellow light time.
Well, I think it might have been in the dilemma zone because I didn't know whether I should have gone or stopped.
Well, dude, you got lucky. You were in the overlap zone. In that zone, it doesn't matter whether you go or stop. You're safe either way.
Okay, well, that's good to know now.
Hey, it's me again. I'm here to give visual aid on the concept of the stop and go zone while approaching a yellow light. Now, there are 2 zones while approaching the yellow light. The purple zone represents the stop zone, and the white part represents the go zone. Now, when you're approaching a yellow light, if the light is yellow while you're in the stop zone, you want to stop, because if you go, you risk a collision with the intersection. However, if you're in the go zone while approaching a yellow light, you want to go, otherwise you risk an accident with the cars behind you. Now, when the two don't touch, there's a middle part, that's called the dilemma zone. In the dilemma zone, you really can't make a right decision, because if you go, you risk a collision in the intersection, and if you stop, you risk a collision with the cars behind you. Now, when the two overlap, that's called the overlap zone. You can't make a wrong decision there, because it's safe either way. That is the stop and go zone.